Well, hello, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us with the conversation with the McGees. And so here lately, we've been coming on. It's been three of us, my daughter, Tiff, and my wife, Bernadine. And she's not here today because she's on grandmother duty. And one of the reasons she's on grandmother duty is because our oldest son's birthday was yesterday. So I want to say happy birthday to Byron.
Happy birthday, Byron.
We're going to
call him Minister Byron.
Minister.
Prophet,
yes,
Byron.
You know why? You know why? Because his mother sent him a video last week about heaven and hell. And I think Byron got saved. For real that time. He said, Mama, I couldn't go to sleep. I was on the floor crying and praying. So I think Byron got saved for real. So Minister Byron, happy birthday
happy
to you.
Birthday.
We love you. But listen, on today, I'm so glad to have my daughter here. See, y'all, prayer works. She's sitting a little closer.
No,
prayer work, she's sitting a little closer. But I thank God for her. My wife will be back with us next time. But, you know, we're living a very strange, a very difficult, a very challenging time. And today we want to talk about music and the lyrics of music. And so, I think more than now, the lyrics are really helping and blessing the people of God. The type of music that you're listening to, especially going back in the day now. Well, my daughter, she was born, but, you know, I was listening to an old Walter Hawkins tune entitled Be Grateful. And so it starts off, God has not promised me sunshine. That's not the way it's going to be. But a little rain mixed with God's sunshine and a little pain. Why? So you can appreciate the good time.
Oh, I knew
be
that.
Grateful.
Yeah,
do you remember?
I remember, yeah.
Okay. And so the thing that I'm learning now is, now that we've been in quarantine for, what has it been, 4 or 5 weeks almost?
Maybe 5 or 6. I done lost count.
Okay. Well, since the government, our governor shut it down, it's been about 4 or 5 weeks. And now I'm grateful for all the opportunities. I had to go to the health club and worked out and didn't want to go. So now I
Absolutely.
Wish I could go. I'd do anything just to get out of the house. But I listened to that song and I'm like, God, we never thought we would experience a day like this. But that really blessed me because, I mean, the song has to be over 30 years old, but it's so prevalent now, you know? And when she gets into it, she said, be grateful. Because even though what we're going through, somebody else is worse off than you, and somebody would love to be in your shoes. So, right now, Tiff, what has been in your heart, or what song has been blessing you, or, you know, that's been on your playlist, or that's been keeping you through this most difficult time?
So, of course, I am a little younger. I don't know the old school songs like that, but I know some. And I'm gonna give you one that's really been dealing with me, especially in this kind of season that I'm in. But before I do that one, so what I do know is, you know, I can spend a lot of time on me, meaning God help me, I need you, and that's real. God, I really do need you. But what I'm learning is, when I take the focus off of me and put it on Him, I have this calm. So there's a song called Most Beautiful. I listened to this version by Maverick City, but you can check that out. It's just, the focus is Jesus, you know? So that's been helping me. There's a song by Elevation Worship called Never Lost. And then there's this old song that I love. And this is Teach Me, O Lord, the ways of thy standard and oh. thy statue. And I, yes,
that's Vanessa Bell, yes, Armstrong.
Yes, that has really that's my prayer. That's my literal prayer. Like, teach me, oh Lord. And, you know, that's what I need.
I thought something was amazing. So, was it I think it was the very first day that we had shut down the church. I think it was the second Sunday in March. It was either the first or the second Sunday. But anyway, so Tiff is our normal worship leader, but she also does worship at another church. And so I think I was playing the piano and she was doing a song at the other church. And we didn't know until after we talked that week that we actually did the same song, which was
Made Away.
Made Away.
By Travis Green.
And the verse started off, here I am.
Standing here, not knowing how I'll get through this test.
Standing here, not knowing how to get through the test. You know?
Yeah.
I thought it was just so ironic that we were both doing the same song, and that song was so prevalent. But now I think that was the first day all churches were shut down, well, especially in Chicago. Not knowing how to get through the test, what were some of the other lyrics?
I'm standing here, I know how to get through this test. Standing here, I know how to get through this test, but holding on to God, you know best. Oh, I forgot. Those lyrics leave me often.
Okay.
But nothing can catch you by surprise. I'm sure I'm jacking these words up, but you've got it figured out. I don't know. But
well,
he made a way.
Right. What? This is the thing. I'm only standing here.
Yeah.
Only because you made a way. Now, we know so many people have been affected by this virus, and so many people have succumbed to it and they've even died from it. But the only reason we're still here is only because he made a way. And I think now it's so important for you to gather your playlist with things that build your faith.
Yeah.
Things that really help you to reach out. And as Tiff was saying, sometimes we're so busy praying about us, and you know, but we also want to know, or some of my friends know, I am here.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to worry. I can see your tears.
Yeah.
I'll be there in a hurry. If you call my name, friends are there to catch you when you fall. Here's my shoulder. You can lean on me. And see, people need to hear that right now. Money is not the answer, and material things are just not doing it for us right now. We just need to know that if I call you, you're there. You know, what was that Hezekiah Walker saying? I need you.
I need you. You need me. We're all a part of God's family. Stand with me.
Yeah.
Agree with me. We're all a part of God's family. It is His will. That every need be supplied. You are important to me, and I need you to survive.
And the next verse was, I pray for you.
You pray for me.
You pray for me.
I love you.
I need you to
survive.
And these are things that we really, you know, need to put into our prayer list, because the truth of the matter is, we do need each other. We're all in it together, and we do need each other. And music has been noticed to be the inspiration of the world. Music had been the hope of the universe, you know, and so when nothing else can have a tendency to bring people together, music can do that, you know. And so I think it's so important to build our playlist, you know, and I love the good, you know, rocky and, you know, the hip hop and all that kind of music. But I'm gonna tell you now, she don't know this because this was way before she was born. Now, some of the older guys, the other young ladies would know this, by Charles Nix, and I think it came out of Detroit, Michigan. He wrote a song called These Are the Times That Try Men's Souls. How befitting is that first line, you know, for where we are right now? The song says, these are the times that try men's souls. Sometimes I wonder if I'll reach my goal. Isn't that kind of like where we are now?
Fully current.
I hear him say, if I'll only be true, if I make one step, he'll make two. And I thought about that song. I haven't thought about that song in years. But Chip, the part that really kept me, and I'm going to let you hear it. There's one line in the song that says, be still my soul. He'll see you through. If you make one step, he'll make two. I mean, and how about 40 years later?
It's needed.
These times are trying our soul. Yeah. You know, now you still have some goals and visions and dreams, right? Mm-hmm. You know, had that ever crossed your mind during the time? I wonder if I'm going to get to do what I started. I'm going to get to finish what I started at that.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Probably more often than it should cross my mind. But yeah, I have those thoughts. Like, I wonder. I mean, because we've never seen something like this before. And so it takes you down that road, that spiral of, okay, I don't know what's going to happen. It may or may, like, it takes you down that road. So yes, I've absolutely had those thoughts.
Well, we are to trust God regardless.
Absolutely.
You know, but if tomorrow is the end of our time, it's just the end of our time. Yeah. You know, but we are to have an agenda. And so favorite young lady to sing is with me here today. Give me a shoulder bump. Give me a shoulder bump. You know, she's so funny. Now, y'all remember last week I told y'all she made me drop the food off and ring the bell and drive away. So, you know, she's got a little... So she said, Dad, can you go get me some Red Lobster? Sound real pitiful. Real pitiful. And I said, yeah, what you want? So she told me, what you want? She said, I'll send the money and you could pick it up for me. Now, normally she say, I'll send the money and if you want something, I'll buy you something too.
We're living in uncertain times.
She we said, don't know. I'll send the money and you can pick it up for me. Lord, she let me buy the food, come into our house, get me a biscuit and eat some of the food.
I stayed upstairs.
Oh, okay. But anyway.
But I did let him come
in. But today, I'm reminded of a song that Tiff did, and it's called Mountains. You remember that? You remember when we went to California and we were actually on top of a mountain?
Yeah.
And it was kind of scary up there. And so those lyrics, some parts of the lyrics she says, I'm surrounded by mountains and I place a name all over them and see them
coming down,
crashing to the ground. You know, and I think we need to really build our faith, knowing that this is not going to be forever. These are mountains, but these mountains are going to come down. I have to ask permission. Is it okay if we show that video?
Absolutely.
Well, I have to pay you to do it.
Nah.
Okay. Because if you remember, I paid for the video shoot. Anyway, let's go to that video, and we'll be right back.
I've been here for so long, became my addiction, like it was a part of me. Surrounded by mountains, I place a name on all of them and see them coming down, crashing to the ground. Surrounded by mountains, I place a name on all of them and see them coming down, crashing to the ground.
So that song was really a blessing. I mean, had you thought about that? But what you're going through right now, what's encountered, I mean, what we're encountering?
Honestly, I had, I forget about that song, which I probably shouldn't, but it took somebody, anytime I'm drawn back to that song, it will be a random comment on YouTube, and I'll get a notification, and then it'll draw me back to the song, and it's like, Tiff, remember these lyrics right here. And
they're very powerful.
Praise God. But that's what I want us all to be encouraged, like to see every mountain and place a name on them and just see them crashing down to the ground. So
and that's what we're believing for. So today we just wanted to talk about music. It's a lot of good music. I'm reminded of the late Whitney Houston and CeCe Winans. Remember they did that song Count on Me? Through thick and thin. You know, a friendship that will never end. And so, you know, we need each other right now. We need each other right now. Want to encourage you to build your playlist with some good music. Don't just keep it all about yourself. Just be grateful, you know, for the time that we have and that we share, you know, and just appreciate God and just know that some way, somehow, we're going to get through this together.
And so I just want to say this before we end it. Find you some good music, right? So find you some music that's going to help you, right? So find some music that inspires you to help others. I have learned that sometimes your answer is in your help for others.
Right.
Sometimes the answer you're looking for is in your help for your brother, your sister. Find that music. Find some just flat out worship music that puts your focus on Jesus and takes you from the cares of the world. And I'm not going to look at them, but find some fun music that you and your family can dance around and love on each other.
I'm not that saved. I don't know how to have fun.
Find some music that will, you know, y'all can love on each other, dance and, you know.
Do the slide together. And honestly, I'm glad you brought that out because it doesn't all have to be Christian and worship music. It could be some good country music. I love me some Dolly Parton. You know, I love you to the moon and back. You know, there are a lot of great artists out there. In fact, to be honest with you, when this whole coronavirus started, I grabbed the old hymn from Deacon Marvin Gaye. And he said, "What's going on?"
Hey, that's what he said. No,
I didn't understand. I'm like, "What's going on?
Yeah.
You tell me what's going on," yeah. You know. But get you some good music. Get you some fun music to really inspire you, to help build hope. And there's a wide variety of music out there. And like I said, it don't always have to be gospel music or Christian music. You know, anybody that knows me, I'm going to stop. Besides Tiff Joy, besides Jermaine Hawkins, besides CeCe Winans, and the late Whitney Houston, anybody that knows me knows I love
Gladys Knight.
Gladys Knight. All right, they know that I love Gladys Knight. And so, you know, she's just very inspirational, very optimistic, and I love her. But listen, thank you so much for listening to our conversation on today. Just want you to know, music is the inspiration of the world. Has it ever just got you through a day?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Got me through yesterday, so yes.
Okay, all right. You know, and one of the things I love about music in your head, you can play the part that you like over and over and over again and don't have to stop. You know, so thank you, Tim,
for
sharing with your dad on today. We miss my wife. And we're also on Grandbaby Watch. We're waiting for Grandbaby number 5, Little Miss Blair. So we hope my wife will be back here next week. But if the grandbaby comes, she may not. But just know that we all love you. Thank you so much for sharing with the conversation with Mickey East. We love you, and we'll see you next time. Oh, we got to do a she get mad because she created this. I love you. My wife makes us do that. Bless you now. Bye-bye.